The following lecture was recorded on the morning of December 26, 1970 in Surat, India.
Samhavanti bhadrani viparitani chanadha karinan gunasangasti dehovan na jhakarmati. So far it has been discussed that those who are impious, they have to be punishable, undoubtedly. But there may be pious activities, so they can avoid punishment. So one may say that I shall avoid impious activities. I shall stick to the pious activities, therefore I shall not be punishable. This is possible. The Shastra says, if one can avoid impious activities, then he is not punishable. But the Yamaduta says that is not possible. The Yamaduta says that one has to become impious. The world is so situated that willingly or unwillingly you have to become impious. Just like those who are in business. Sometimes or always they have to make some transaction in black market. Without doing that, his business cannot be continued. There are many cases, practical examples, that in business field, without going through the black market, sometimes there is no profit of the business. Therefore, the Yamaduta says, karinam gunasangasti. Because we are in this material world, we have to associate with the three kinds of material modes of nature. And even though I try to keep myself on the quality of goodness, the association is so bad that I have to become a criminal under the association of other qualities, just like tamago. Therefore, we are singing every morning, Sangasara Dava Nalalilu, the blazing fire of this material existence, Davana, forest fire. It is not that one intends that fire may take place, no. But in course of time, in course of seasonal changes, the fire takes place automatically. How can I avoid? That is not possible. That is clearly stated by Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita, that jagnyartha karma, anatra karma vandha. If you don't act for yajna, for Vishnu, or if you don't become a Vaishnava and simply devote your life for serving Krishna, then you are bound up by all your activities, either pious or impious. Nāsamnāt Thakur therefore sings, karmakānda jñānakānda sakali viṣer bhāṇḍa. Amrita boliya jīva khāy, nāna jani bhraman kare, kadarja bhakkhan kare, tār janma adhapate jāy. Karmakanda, in the Vedas, there are three different types of activities. One is called Karmakanda, the other is called Jnanakanda, and the last is Upasana Kanda. In the Upasana Kanda, when you are elevated to the Vishnu Upasana. And you come to the understanding that Vishnu is the Supreme Personality of Godhead and He is to be worshipped. Vishnu Aradhati Pungsham. This is our Varnashram Dharma, which is now running on as Hindu Dharma. Varnashram Dharma means to please Lord Vishnu. Varnashram, the four ashram and four varnas, Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra, the four varnas and four ashramas, Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyas. All their aim is how to please Vishnu. That is Varnashram. Not that by force I am Brahmin, I am Kshatriya, I am this, I am that, and fighting one another. No, the real aim, Varnashrama Charavata, Purushina Parapuman, Vishnu Aradhate Pumsa, Nanna Tattus Karanam. Therefore, a civilized country or a civilized society, unless they accept this Varnashrama Dharma, that is not human society. That is not accepted as human society. That is almost animal society. Without accepting this Varnashram Dharma, that is the beginning of real human civilization. When they accept these four divisions of Varnas and according to quality, as Bhagavan Krishna says, Chaturvarna Maya system guna karma vibhava. Not by what? That has killed this Vedic civilization. When people began to claim to become Brahmin, Kshatriya, simply by birth, the whole structure has been dismantled. That is to be revived. We have to pick up Brahmins from all parts of the world. That is Vedic civilization. But Krishna says that Chaturvarnamaya system, I have created this division of four varnas according to quality. Narad says, Jasahi Jatlakhalangshad Varnavi Banjakam. There are symptoms for ascertaining a particular class of varna, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya. Jadi annatrapi drishyeta. If you find that quality, that symptom, in anywhere, in other place, you have to accept. If you find the Brahmical qualification in Europe and America, somebody, not all, then you have to accept you as Brahmin. That is the basic Indian. And if you think, he is European, he is Mlecha, he is Javas, no, but when you see that he has got the Brahminical qualification, Vishnu Aradhata, he is simply engaged in worshipping Vishnu, you have to accept him as the first class varna or the Brahmin. Unless you become such liberal and really under the regulation of Vedic principles, this so-called Vedic civilization is already spoiled and it cannot be protected. So, guna sangha, association with the particular type of guna, quality, that is essence. We have to find out the symptoms, just like Bhagavad Gita says. Now, a man is dying. A man is dying, These are very clearly stated. Tatha dehantarang prati dhiratatanam hingam. When a man is taking another, he is about to accept another body, that means dying, a dying man, leaving this body. Those who are crying, oh, my father is dying, my son is dying, they are not advanced. That was the first instruction to Arjuna, that you are lamenting on the body. No learned man does this. That means you are a fool. Asatyanasutastam prajnavaransuhat. My dear Arjuna, you are talking just like a very learned man, but your symptom is like a fool. That is going on. So, dhirastatta namayati, one can understand that this my father or my son or my relative or my friend is dying, he is accepting another body. And what kind of body he is accepting, that you also can foretell. If you are learned, dhira satanam, dhira, if you are dhira, if you are adhira, adhira means this ordinary man, sensuous, adhira. Those who are conducted or directed by the senses, they are called adhira. And dhira means they have controlled the senses. That is called dhira. Though one who is not agitated by the dictation of the senses, he is called dhira. Just like Lord Shiva is described in Kumar Sambhava as dhira. He was in meditation naked, and the demigod's plan was that Lord Shiva must give birth to a boy who can actually become the commander-in-chief of the demigods. That was their plan. So Parvati was induced, young girl Parvati, and she began to worship the genitals of Lord Shiva, the Shivalinga, worship. So still Lord Shiva was in meditation. So that time, Kalidas is describing, here is a dhira. Dhira. Dhira means a man is sitting idle, and a young girl is touching the genital, but still he is not agitated. That is called dhira. Not by simply seeing any young girl, beautiful girl, one becomes agitated. They are adhira. So they are asked, dhiras and adhiras. Dhiras means those who have control over the senses. They are called dhiras. Every word, Sanskrit word, has got very deep meaning. Therefore, there is no comparison of the Sanskrit language in the whole world. It is called Sanskrita. Sanskrita means purified. The grammatical composition, the rules, that so much nicely, and it is called Devanagari. Devanagari means in the higher planetary system where demigods live, they speak in Sanskrit. In Vaikuntha also they speak in Sanskrit. The Sanskrit language is so uplifted. So, and in India also, formerly, amongst the learned circle, the language used was in Sanskrit. Therefore you find all the Vedic scriptures. Even 500 years ago, just like our Goswami, they wrote all their books in Sanskrit. therefore there is no provincialism. Because the learned circle, they talked in Sanskrit, they wrote in Sanskrit, it doesn't matter whether he is born in Bengal or in Gujarat or Madras. When the learned man will speak and write, they will write in Sanskrit, speak in Sanskrit. So this learning was especially entrusted to the Brahmins because they were the leaders of the society, head of the society. Just like your head is the leader of your bodily activity. Similarly, the Brahmins were head. So in this way, the subject matter is that in this material world, the guna sangha, you have to associate with particular type of quality. And according to that quality, your character, your behavior, your activities are molded. And according to that symptoms of your association with the particular type of quality, your caste or category is selected. That is called guna karma vibhava. These are all scientific. They are now, the government wants that there should be no caste system. But how can you say there is no caste system? There are gunas. How can I avoid caste? There must be a class of men, very intelligent. They are called Brahmins by their gunas. And there must be a class of men, Kshatriyas, by the particular type of guna. And there must be a class of men, mercantile or Vaishnavas, by the particular type of gunas acquired. And there must be a class of men, Sudra. So the guna sangasti, so according to guna, therefore the Jamadutta says, Karinam guna sangas. Anyone who is engaged in activities, activities means, I have already explained, that karma, karma means I work, I get some profit and I utilize it for my sense gratification. They are karma. So work is not prohibited. You cannot stop working. But the purpose of working, according to the purpose of working, the guna is detected. What is the purpose of this work? Karinam guna sangasti. Dehavan is akarmaki, nahi akarmaki. Dehavan, one who has accepted this body, he has to work. Without working, he cannot live. Then it is said, Jina javan jatha dharma, dharma birha samihitaha, sai vatat phalang bhungte, tatha tavat amutra bhai. Just like in this life, dharma dharma, suppose I have committed some criminal act. Shall I be punished? That's a fact. Similarly, if I have acted piously, I will be rewarded. Yagyas dana tapakriya. Those who are performing yagyas, giving in charity, those who are undergoing austerities for self-purification, they will be rewarded with sukham, with happiness. Why do you find so many different kinds of men? One body is enjoying, one body is born with silver spoon in the mouth, and one body is born from the very beginning, injection of the doctor. The child is born and immediately it requires an injection. Why this is? That is due to, as it is said, jino javan jatha dharma, adharma, dharma driha samir. These are being automatically prakita kriyamanani. They are under the laws of nature. One body is suffering, one body is enjoying. You cannot rectify it. Therefore, those who are engaged in philanthropic work, this man is suffering, I shall give him some food, I shall give him some shelter, I shall take to hospital. You can do so. From your part, it is five activities, but you cannot give relief. That is not possible. Your sympathy for the suffering humanity is nice. It is because if you think that so many people are suffering from disease, let me open an hospital and give, let me give free treatment. From your part, it is all right. You are doing some pious activity. You'll enjoy the fruit of your past. But the person to whom you want to give relief, he'll not be relieved. He'll suffer. Therefore it is useless. The only relief work is if you can induce one man to Krishna consciousness. That is the only relief. Otherwise all futile. You cannot get a man suffering by your hospitalizing. No, that is not possible. That is from your part it is good. Try to understand. But you cannot give relief. So many hospitals are open all over the world. Today patients are in Jesus. That's all. Patients are increasing everywhere. How many hospitals you have got in this country? In America there are very, very nice, big hospitals. What is that hospital, mental, in New York? Bellevue. They're for treating mental disorders. The mental disorder persons are increasing only, crazy fellow. Is it not? You have to simply increase the bedding, that's all. Beds are increasing, not the patients are decreasing. Beds are increasing. You have got some money, you can increase some beds, but the patient will not decrease. That is increase. Gunasangas, because they are associated with different types of gunas, how can you check it? That is not possible. And if you teach people to become above the gunas, that is real beneficial. What is that? To make a person above the gunas without being touched by the gunas. Sagunan samati taitan brahma bhuyaya kalpati. How? Mancha abhyabhicharini bhakti yogena jasevati. He becomes. He is not infected by the gunas. Therefore, this is the only means of welfare activities to the human society. How to make them Krishna conscious. This is the only. Any other activities for welfare activities for the human species, they are simply futile. That's a fact. Jena javana jathadharma jathadharma dharma diha samihita saiva tatphalam bhukte. Jena javana jathadharma adharma and dharma. According to that, one has to accept a particular type of body. He has to be placed in a particular position, sthana and danda. He has to suffer. How it is so, that is also explained. That, just like I was trying to explain from the Bhagavad Gita, dhira sattva. Dhira, one is learned, he can know that this man, my father or relative or friend or son is now dying. Where he'll go? How he'll accept the other body? That is also explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Udhaṁ gacchanti sattva. If you see that this man was in satogun, satogun means in a brahminical qualification. Sattva sama dhamma tripikya ajyava jnanam vijnanam astikam, as the symptoms are described. This is science. Just like you can, in medical science, a drug has a particular characteristic. When you analyze that characteristics are right, then a medical man accepts, yes, this is pure drug. Similarly, everything you have to accept by the symptoms, by the characteristics. So if you see that this man dying as a Vaishnava or as a Brahman, sattva, then he is going to Vaikuntha, or higher planet system, the Brahma Loka, Tapa Loka, Jana Loka, Maha Loka. It is hardly be that. So, urdhangatthasi sattva. You have to see, how you have to know what is satagon, what is rajagon, what is tamagon, what is mixed gon. If you learn it, then you can foretell that this man is going there. These indications are there in the Bhagavad Gita. Just like Krishna says, Jati deva brata devant. If you know that this man was performing this worship of such and such demigods, then he is going to such demigods. Jati deva brata devant. Pitrin Jati Pitri Brata. Those who are fond of, those addicted to karma kanda, tarpan. Pitri Tarpan, they will go to the Pitri Lokas. But how you can say, whatever you do, that is all right. Hey, you can go to God. This is nonsense. Where do you get this idea? That whatever you do, whatever you worship, ultimately, it is God. No? It is clearly stated, Jānti Deva Vrata Deva. Pitrin Janti Pitri Bhutaha Bhutetya Janti Bhutani Mad Jajin Hopi Janti Ma. Those are my devotees. They will come to me. How you can say that worshipping a demigod can go to the kingdom of God? No. This is ignorance. And in other place it is said, Bhagavad Gita, kāmaśtasya hitajñāna jajanti anna devata. Those who are worshippers of devi gods, they are hitajñāna. Hitajñāna has been commented by Vishnu Chakravarti as Nasta Buddha. Nasta Buddha, one whose intelligence is lost. They are addicted to the worship of demigods. Antavattu phalam desham. Well, we get some profit by worshipping demigods. That's our life. But antavattu phalam desham. How long we'll enjoy that profit? Tadbhavati alpa medasam. They are meant for less intelligent classes. And those who are actually intelligent, Sarvadhamman Parittajya Mami, he worships Krishna. That's how. He is actually interested. Because his result is permanent. If one worships Krishna according to the system, then Tattadeham Punarjanayati, that is the solution. After this body, he is no more coming to this material world. Therefore, that is real solution of life. Our suffering is, we do not know what is our suffering. The suffering is repeated, repetition, acceptance of birth and death. That is our real suffering. When you get a body, you also suffer. But if you get a good body, you do not suffer very much. But that is not a solution. You have got now this very good body, you are enjoying. But in the next life, you may not. So that is not a solution. Therefore, for temporary benefit, if anyone worships the demigod, he is to be called as lost of all intelligence. Therefore, Krishna says, Mamekam, don't bother yourself with any other worship. Simply, Manmana Bhava Madhbhakta Majjari Maham Namaskuru. This is Gita. Simply concentrating on Krishna. We are preaching this Krishna consciousness means as simply concentrating on Krishna. That is real Krishna, Bhagavad Gita. Then he becomes above the transcendental to all activities of the gunas. That song, Narottam Das Thakur's song, Karma Kanda, Gana Kanda, Sakali Vishesh Bhanda. Karma Kanda, fruity activities, Gana Kanda, philosophical speculation. So now, Narottam Das Thakur says that both these are pots of poison. Karma Kanda, Gana Kanda, Sakali Vishesh Bhanda. Bhanda means pot. And Vishesh means a poison. But Amrita Bolia Jiva Khat. If some foolish person accepts karmakanda and jnanakanda by his foolishness, Amrita Bolia, Tara Janma Adhapatis, he got the chance of human form of life to make a solution of all problems by worshipping Krishna and being Krishna conscious. Now he loses the chance. He is attracted by karma kanda to be elevated to the heavenly kingdom, or jnana kanda to become one with the supreme jnana kanda. That means he is missing the chance. A very nice song. Karma kanda, jnana kanda, sakali vishesh bhanda. They are all poisonous pots. If one is allured to this poisonous pot, then Nana Joni Brahman Kare. This is Jnana, it is Jnana Kanda. One is thinking, meditating that I am becoming one with the Supreme. That is also a false idea. That is also a false idea. Because the Bhagavad Gita it is said, Bhavanam Janmanamante Jnanavan. Those are following the path of Jnana, Jnanavan. As Bhavanam Janmanamante, there are many births, so how he becomes one with the Supreme. If he has to test many births, then where is the mixing up with the Supreme? That is a false idea. Or bewildered idea. And in another place in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said, Jannir Vindyakha Vimukta Manina Tai Astabhavad Abhishuddha Buddha. These persons, those who are contemplating that I have become Narayan, this Mahabhava, every sannyasi addresses another sannyasi, Narayan, Namo Narayan. That means he has become Narayan. So, vimukta manina. To become Narayan means he is now liberated from this material contamination. So, Bhagavad says that such kind of self-completion thinking that I have become Narayan, they are abhishuddha buddha. Abhishuddha buddha means their intelligence is not yet clear. Abhishuddha Buddha. Why? Tai astabhavat. Because they have not yet learned to surrender unto the lotus feet of Narayana. They are trying to become Narayana. Jannera vindakha vimukta manina. They are called vimukta manina. I have become liberated. Manina. Manina means falsely thinking. Jannera vindakha vimukta manina. Tai asvabhava. And because they have not learned to surrender unto the lotus feet of Narayana, they are avishuddha buddha. Their intelligence is impure, avishuddha. So, what is the result of becoming such impure intelligence? Ariyakichena parang padang tataha. By undergoing severe penances and austerities, they rise to up to the Brahma Jyoti position. But they fall down again. Ariyakichena parang padang tataha patanti adha. Again they come down to this material world. Anadita jismat anghaya, simply by neglecting your lotus feet. These are the statements of the Vedic literature. So, you can understand at the time of death how one is being promoted or degraded. Uddhangat santi sattas par. If a man was in actual good, mode of goodness, he will be elevated. Or, just like Bhagavad Gita says, madhyajina api janti ma. If he is a devotee of Krishna, he has whole time, whole life, he has simply worked for Krishna. Then Krishna says, madhyajina api janti ma. Then he is going to Krishna loka. And he is going to Brahma loka. He is going to Janaloka. If one is learned, just like by astrological science, one can understand the future. Similarly, in the Shastras, everything is there. Here it is stated that Jino Javan Jatha Dharma, Jatha Adharma, Dharma Veha Samihita, Saiva Tat Phalang Bhumte, Tatha Tavat Amutra Bhai. As one is enjoying the fruits of dharma and adharma in this life, similarly one can understand how he is going to enjoy or suffer in the next life. Amutra. Amutra means next life. Saiva tat phalang bhunte tatha tavat amutra bhai. Jateha deva prabhari taividhya उपलब्धते भूतेषु गुणवैचित्र्यात् तथा अन्यत्र अनुमीयते. Very nice instruction. Just like you can see that by committing sinful acts one is suffering, if not bodily, but by the state laws he is suffering. Similarly, you can anumiyate, you can imagine, you can perceive, you can hypothesize that this man has committed such kind of sin, he is going to suffer. He has not suffered in this life, then he has to suffer next life. In the Manusangita, it is stated that when a man is hanged by the king, it is a favor to the man. It is a favor to the man. If he is not punished life for life in this life, then he will have to suffer in the next life in more with compound interest. Therefore, the law says that this man has committed a murder, he must be killed so that he may be saved from the sufferings of the next life. There is a Manusangita, it is stated. So there are many things to save a person from the father suffering. And the best service to the humankind is to make him a devotee. Devotee. Karmani ought to teach him how to surrender to Krishna. This is plainly stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Sarvadhanman parityajyamamekam saranam bhaja. Aṅtāṁ sarva-pāpibhaṁ akhaśyāṁ. The suffering is due to papa. So Krishna takes charge of the person, surrendered soul, and he gives assurance that I shall protect you. He can do so. Because he is the Supreme Lord. Just like a man is condemned to death, but he submits petition to the king or the president, he may be saved. That is in the power of the president or the king. By law he cannot be saved, but by the mercy of the king, king's mercy, he can be saved. Similarly, Krishna is the supreme king. When he takes charge of you and he gives you assurance that I shall give you protection, why do you hesitate? Just surrender and become Krishna conscious and your problem is solved. Thank you very much. So, the only solution of all problems is to become Krishna conscious. Is there any disagreement? Boliye.
That is the only solution.
Now you can understand how much important is this Krishna consciousness movement. This is the Shreya. Pranayirathai Vyavata, Shreya Asaram. Everyone should join this movement for the human welfare activities. With their life, with their money, with their intelligence, with their words.
There's mostly in the Bhagavad Gita, I think it's the 14th chapter, when you say that describing the modes of nature, you say they have to understand how these modes act, how they bite, and how they give liberation. My understanding is that liberation only comes from beyond the modes of material nature, from the Krishna from
a but you have to go to the highest platform gradually. If you take, just like you have to rise to the topmost story. So there is staircase and there is elevator also. The ultimate aim is Vishnu. So there, the topmost. So you can go by the step by step. This is one method. And if you get the easiest method, elevator, then you call us to go. Both ways you can go. But this will take many, many years. Bhavanam janmanam ante jnanavanam prabhadyate. After many, many births, one who is actually jnanavan, wise, he surrenders. And another, he takes the word of Krishna immediately surrender. It is not that they will not be going to that post. They will take time, step by step, by karma kanda, dana kanda. Therefore he says, Bhavanamya, why should you wait for Bhavanam Janma? Why don't you take advantage of the elevator? Why you are determined? No, I shall go step by step. Is that very intelligent? And two things are there. In your country, you have got experience, 100-story building, and if you go step by step, it will take 3 hours. What is that building? Empire building in New York. Yeah? If you go step by step, then it will take 3 hours. And if you take the advantage of the elevator, you go in 3 seconds. Why one should be so fool to go to the topmost flat in 3 years? When Krishna is offering, he's coming personally, canvassing, you surrender. Why this foolish person refuse? Why this foolishness? And why this foolishness to making, wrong commentation, not to surrender to Krishna? You see the foolishness of the people, the so-called scholars, so-called swamis, how they are misleading people. Andhajathandhairupaniyamana. A blind leader is leading many blind followers. Nati vidu sāsagatiṃ hi viṣṇu durāsayādiva. They are trying to be happy by making adjustment of this material condition. There is another foolishness. That is not possible. Devidhi sādhumanji. Everything is stated very nicely in the Bhagavad Gita. But they wrongly comment and mislead the people. Therefore, our business is to present Bhagavad Gita as it is and give the right direction to the people. That is our business. Boliye Doctor Sir. Theek hai ki nahi?
Is it right to say that this path of doing good work is completely impossible in the Kali Yuga? That nobody can do it in Kali Yuga because of that?
But when you are doing the utmost good, why you are anxious about doing other good work?
So I just want to establish that this God is...
Even if you do some good work, but the result is temporary. Suppose if you give medicine to a person, that is good work, nice work. But do you think that he will not be attacked with disease anymore? Is it possible, doctor? So what is the value of this good work? Puna puna charvita charvanana, feeling the feeling. Suppose a patient is coming to him, suffering from some infectious disease, he's infecting, say, syphilis. Then doctor gives him injection, cures him, and he again does the same thing. Again comes to the doctor. The real doctor, he'll advise him, why you are doing this? And the doctor who says, let him come, I get my money. That is another. So this kind of advice is like that, let him come and let me have my money. And the real advice is that you become Krishna conscious. So your problem is solved. That is not my imagination, and that is Krishna says. Our position is that we simply speak what Krishna says, that's all. We haven't got to manufacture ideas. So don't take the trouble of manufacturing ideas. We simply, as a peon, convey the ideas given by Krishna, that's all. Therefore it is being successful. and it will be success. Because there is no adulteration. Pure milk will be accepted everywhere. And if you mix it with water, you will have to find out a particular tribe or custom. So this revolutionary movement is eyesore for many. But if this movement becomes successful, there are so-called so many philanthropists, they will have no position. There is economic theory. Bad money drives away good money. So, when the good money is not available in the market, the bad money is there. There is an example in the Bhagavad that in the rainy season, when the sky is covered with clouds, at times the glowworms become very prominent. But when the sky is clear, there is moonshine, this glowworms has no meaning. So, in the world there are so many glowworms, because real knowledge is covered. They do not know, they have forgotten what is Krishna. Therefore all these rascal glowworms, they are prominent. But this movement is clearing the clouds, bringing out the moon. Sriyakkaidavachandrikavitaranam. Sriyakkaidavachandrikavitaranam. So there is no use of anyone but the glow on. Chaitanya Chandroda. The rising of the moon of Lord Chaitanya, Chaitanya Chandra. Now he is rising gradually, just like moon rises gradually. And one day becomes full moon. Similarly, this Chaitanya movement is rising gradually. One day it will clear the sky and all these glowworms will go out. There is no more any place for all the glowworms. So you be decided and determined to push on this movement, Chaitanya Chandra. That's your duty. You are coming out as a very intelligent nation, very rich nation. Utilize this opportunity. To clear out all this glow-up and bring the Chaitanya Chandra. And the method is so simple, Hare Krishna, that's all. Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtana. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives you the benediction and you go on pushing the Sri Krishna Sankirtana and everything is clear. Chaita Darpana Mahajana. Don't be after glowworms. Just be after the moon, full moon. Chaitanya Chandra.
It's so kind that our Krishna consciousness
is more than God. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. any man go, Krishna consciousness movement, in any temple, any place, he is immense food stuff. He eats whatever he likes. Is it not? Right? This Krishna consciousness movement is not dry speculation. Simply here and there is no prasadam. No, there is prasadam. By mental speculation and simply wasting time. No, it is practical. You get some factual knowledge, you take some prasadam, you dance very nicely and chant, very musical, susukham. That is what Gita says, susukham. It is very pleasing to execute this Krishna consciousness movement. Susukham kartum abhayam. And whatever you do, whatever percentage you make progress, it is never to be annihilated. Permanent, abhayam. So take to this moment and be happy. That is all. Do you agree or not? What is your opinion?
I think it's very good.
Yes.
No,
that's all I can do. This too. Nice Bengali poetry. Krishnanam karo bhai arsham niche. Palaibar path nai jom ache piche. Ki bala, Dr. Mukherjee? Palaibar path nai jom ache piche. You cannot escape the Jamaraj. He is after you. Take shelter of Krishna. He will give you protection. Now you execute the order of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Go village to village, town to town, all over the world, and preach this Krishna consciousness. And it is proved, they will accept. Is it not? You can say better because you are American. I may be over hopeful, but what is your experience? Anywhere you open a branch, immediately it is accepted. As if they are prepared to take this Krishna consciousness. That is our experience. Every month we are opening a branch. Now, what is the calculation? Suppose we are working for the last 4 years. The 4 years means 48 months. Is it not?
Yeah.
We have got 45 branches. That means, proportionately, we have opened one branch every month since we began work. Is it not unique? In 48 months, we have opened, not 48 months actually, we have begun a real propaganda from 1968, January. How many months? 68, 69, 70. 24 months and 70, another 12 months, December. 36 months. And taking previously few months, actually the proportion is that we have opened every month a branch.